A central monitoring platform supports risk assessment, and this can be your starting place for working inside the system. Traditionally, risk assessments can happen way before a trial goes live, and we can use this opportunity to identify risk and perhaps design some risk away from a protocol. The process typically starts with us identifying critical data and associated critical processes, so that we identify what are the really important pieces of this trial and the things that we definitely want to protect, and we want to make sure that we have no negative impact on these areas of data collection. Once the critical data and processes have been documented, users can then move on to an assessment questionnaire where we can look at different risk scenarios and then assess them on the basis of impact, probability, and detectability. And that is configurable if you wanted to move away from those three dimensions and do something different. The content of the questionnaire is also completely configurable and can come from one of our templates, one of your templates, or you can just create your own assessment for a given clinical trial. It's broken down into categories over on the left-hand side. And then within each category, we see different risk statements or questions, but we've had the opportunity to grade as we've gone along. As we go through and we score individual risk scenarios, we can also move on and we can record additional information inside the risk assessment. So these additional fields that you see here are ones that I have chosen to add to my risk assessment because I want to bolster the documentation that the system is creating for me. As I scroll down, I can also see that this risk is linked to certain critical processes and pieces of critical data. And I can also see, because this risk has been managed through to completion, we have also linked a key risk indicator to control this risk. But more of that in a moment. Each of the risks that you identify are then summarized for you in the risk control tab. And initially they would start with an unmitigated state. And then it's our opportunity to come in and review those assessed risks from the questionnaire. And then we can decide to implement our own risk controls to control those identified scenarios. So those could be tasks and things that we would do outside of the platform, but they can also be metrics such as key risk indicators. And here I've used both, including one of our standard metrics to measure data entry performance. And I can also, within the risk assessment, set my own thresholds for that metric within the trial. So my definition of the metrics that I need, the thresholds that I'm going to use, is linked directly to the risk assessment process so that I have that traceability ultimately across those metrics all the way back into risk assessment. The platform will support iterative risk assessment processes. So this is something that you would continue to revisit and reevaluate over time. We have the opportunity to export all the information in a single PDF for each individual version. And now when we can see scenarios such as the risk score changing here, I might be interested in knowing what has actually moved within version 2 of the risk assessment compared with version 1, and I can select those and run a comparison report so the system will summarize those differences for me. Once we've completed our risk assessment process, we're then ready to go and deploy those metrics inside the central monitoring platform so that we can actually go and monitor for those risk scenarios.